this video, we're going to be doing some micro fishing because it's cold outside and the bigger bass ain't willing to bite as much. So we're going to see if the smaller ones will. So we're going to be hitting a lake and a river for this. So stay tuned, see if we can make it happen. So caught us a little baby bass. So that's a good sign. If a little baby bass is gonna get it, a big one will too. So I always look for little signs like that. There we go. Came right out. There he is. Just a little guy, but we're gonna get him back. Gotta be like the worst chub ever. There he goes, and he's back in the water. Thread that baby on there. God, that one little fish did some damage to the worm. Got sharp little teeth. Got a little fish. Oh geez, look at that. We gill hooked that poor guy. Wow, that's a odd looking bass. Oops. And again, he's down in the little ditch. Man, I don't like coming down here. But I'll save the little guy's life since I messed him up in the first place. Let's take a look at that guy. It's pretty crazy. I think that's a spotted bass. Let's get him back in. And he's back in. We got a good one here. Well, not a good one, but shit, better than we've been getting. Shit, he's a handful. Look at that. So that guy is pretty fat. Look at that. Alrighty, let's get him back in the water here. And I don't really want to chuck these big ones. The little ones, I don't really care about, but these big ones. gotta treat him nice. Not that this is humongous, but he might be one day. There he goes. Let's see if there's another one down over here. Got one. Look at that, next freaking cast, we got one. But you know, I mean, he's small, he's nothing big, but shit, that worm, it's working for us. Boom. Even though he's a little guy, look, I mean, look how fat he is. He's like, I don't know, it just surprises me how small these fish are, and they're freaking fat. There he goes. Alright, so I'm going to thread another worm on and probably cast a few more times here. Trust me, I would love to get into a big one. I just don't think they're over here. Probably going to have to walk over to the other side to get lucky. So, I don't know, man. They're stacked over there. I keep throwing over there and I keep getting some. So, shit, not too bad. Worm came right out. Alright. And there's that one. Jeez, I mean, these guys are fat. But there he is. And get him over here and release him. Boom, there he goes. So, we just pulled in that little guy right there. Man, a lot of little fish today. So, I guess we might as well make this a micro fishing video. So, there he is. Becoming a pro at micro fishing. Got him right in the side of the jaw and that gill plate. But we got it out. Let's take a look at this guy. Boom, there he is. Let's get him back in the water. Got us another one. A little bit bigger, not much though.
there's that one. Man, they're fat. Right. So, got another one. Man, I mean, when these fish are stacked up, they are stacked up. And that's exactly what happens in fall. Half of them will go deep, the other half will stay along the shoreline and group up in groups. That's why I keep throwing in the same spot. And as you see, it's working and we're getting those fish. All right. Today's definitely a worm day here. It usually always is at this spot. There's a fallen tree over there. And I just got that feeling. If I go over there and do the quick dip, we might pull a decent sized fish out of there. Well, better than what we've been getting recently. We pulled another little guy out. He's real small. There he is. Lot of spotted bass. Man, this little guy is a fat one. Oop. And he goes in the gravel. Wanna take a quick look at him real quick. He's got like 50 pounds of gravel on him, but let's get him back in the water. Kind of chuck them over here. Wow, there's a whole school of little bass. All right, so we got that guy again. Little guy that's a fat one. Look at that. He's pretty fat for as small as he is. We're going to release him up over here. Okay. That's another little chunk. Boom, he was barely hooked.
But there he is.
Micro fishing at its best. Still trying to find that good one, but if we can't, hey, we still had a good day micro fishing. Got him. He was stuck on a branch there for a second. But we got him. Yeah, a lot of these spotted bass today. Only thing really hitting. But again, fat little ones for micro fishing. I could deal with that. I hate micro fishing and they're really, really small. So at least they're decent for micro fishing. There we go. So we got another little chunker. And I think after I'm done fishing this spot, I'm gonna hit the river and see what I can get into as far as micro fishing over there. So let's put this guy back. And there he goes. Think we were gonna get him. He was stuck on that branch. We got him. Again, you know, it's right in the side of his jaw there. Jesus. So hard to get it out when it's like that. There we go. So, there he is, another little fat one. And we definitely caught 30 plus fish in the time we've been here micro fishing. And there he goes. So I'm gonna move spots in, see if we can get a little bit bigger one. Right between those logs and this guy came out of nowhere and grabbed it. Although we were hoping it was a bigger one, but hey, bite's a bite, fish a fish, we'll take it. There he goes. Alright guys, I made it here to the little river spot, but where I wanted to fish, I'm not able to because there's all kinds of long grass over there and I had a run in with a rattlesnake, and that's where I draw the line. I am not going through no long grass just to fish. So I came around the other way, and it's really shallow right here. It's not as good as over there, but we're gonna see if we can still make it happen. Oh. All right, we got one. Look at that, guys. Just a little baby one, but real little. So I'm not able to use my rooster tail, or I mean my worm on the jig head. Look at that guy, he's having trouble getting out of there. But what I am doing is a rooster tail instead of that worm on the jig head, because it just, I need something with weight that's gonna get me out there into the deeper water. So I wanted to fish this river for you guys, but doesn't seem like that's in the playing cards, because we just can't get out into deeper water, because like I said, I am not going through that tall grass. There's a huge ass rattlesnake in there. I heard it rattle and then I seen the body and I've got the hell out of there. Got into another one. So it's about the size that we had that had got off. All right, and he's off. Oh shit, look at that. Got a fish. Alright, so that's probably the best one that we've gotten out of this river here. There he is. So, I think he's gonna be the last one. And that's definitely gonna wrap this one up here. Jeez Louise, man. He is really stuck good. Ugh, there we go. Got it. Alright. One more look at him. There he is. Let's get him back in the water here. Alright. So, that's going to end it. And we were just casting out down over there in that deep water. And well, it's not so deep, I'd say it's probably like maybe a foot and a half to 2 feet. But if you like these videos, you know what to do, and that's gonna wrap this one up. All right guys, that's gonna do it, and I hope you like this video on micro fishing with a worm on a jig head. You can catch just about anything, any size. So we hit that lake and we got into tons of them. Nothing really big, it was just a bunch of little small ones, but that's why I'm calling it micro fishing. And then we tried hitting this river over here, and the spot I wanted to go to was like overgrown with long grass, and I had a run in with the rattlesnake. I seen that and I was like, I'm out of here. So that's what brought me to that other spot, and it was really shallow, but we still managed to bring in three small little bass off of the rooster tail. So if you like these videos and you want to see more, you know what to do, and I'll see you guys on the next one.